community activist. He is the founder and executive officer of Grand Hustle. He launched his film company, Grand Hustle Films, in 2007. T.I. knows the excitement, danger, and pain of which he writes. Preceding the release of his eighth studio album, Trouble Man, and just in time for the premiere season two of his hugely successful VH1 series, T.I. and Tiny, The Family Hustle, Grammy-winning artist actor T.I. pens a powerful follow-up to his street-lit epic, Power and Beauty. Adding to all this, T.I. can be seen alongside Kelsey Grammer on Starz' hit political comedy, Boss. He and his wife, Tiny, are involved in charities and community outreach with children and those suffering from Alzheimer's. Baby, you hit that one more time. Oh, you're not there? Okay. Please welcome T.I. to the stage.
Gunshots. Oh, shit.
What's happening? I don't know exactly how I feel about this whole living legends thing. This is, you know how old I am? Do y'all know how old I am? I had a birthday yesterday, you know what I'm saying? I ain't that old, you know what I'm saying? Thank you. And I'm glad that Brother Divine came up here, you know, and received me, because that made me comfortable to say what I got to say.
Let's go, team!
Now, in this place we know and love, called Atlanta, I came up, man, from, you know, absolutely nothing, zero. I saw things on TV, I heard things on the radio when I had an opportunity to, but I had absolutely zero access. I did not know JD, I did not know Divine, I did not know LA, I knew no one, you know what I'm saying? And it seemed as though me and my guys, in doing what we were doing, right, wrong, or indifferent, the road just continued to lead to dead ends. You know what I'm saying? There was no outlet for me. There was no acceptance of open arms anywhere for me. There was no opportunity for me to show people what I had to offer so they could tell me whether or not I was good enough. The first opportunity I got was the first deal I got signed. And that was KP, Kawan KP Prater. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna tell you how that happened. My cousin too, God rest his soul, he was very, very good friends with a young gentleman that you may know by the name of DJ Toon. Mm-hmm. DJ Toon introduced me to another young gentleman that you may know by the name of Jason G. Mm-hmm. Now, we all formed an alliance. Me, my cousin too, Jason Jeter, DJ Toon. And we said, man, you know what? Together we're gonna show people that you have what it takes and more to outdo anything that anyone else got to put out. I said, well, you know what I'm saying? You speaking my language, let's get it. Now see, the problem that they had with me was that I was 17, 18 years old, with two felonies under my belt, on probation, and still selling crack on a day-to-day basis. Now, they had to sit down with me. My cousin too, Jason G, DJ Toon, they said, hey listen, we are investing our time, our money, our efforts, our energy into you, and you are taking chances that it could flush all this down the toilet. And you know me, I was 18, I think I'm bad now, you should have seen me at 18. I was small with a big head, and I said, well, I tell you what then, Sean. You want me to stop doing what I'm doing, then you take me somewhere right now and then let me do my thing and then give me an opportunity and I'll stop what I'm doing. And you know Jason, if anybody know Jason, y'all know when he know he got you, he look at you and say, "You really mean that, yo?" So he just happened to be an intern at Patchwork, you know what I'm saying? And that was a group that just happened to be recording at Patchwork by the name of PA, Parental Advisory. So he just happened to call. He said, "Hey man, I got a guy y'all need to hear, man." They said, "Bring him in." He brought me in, Reach, Mello, was in there working on the AL. He said, "Hey man, it's Till. He go hard." They looked at me, they say, "You go hard?" I say, "Hell yeah." They said, "Well, can you rap to this?" I say, "Where the booth at, nigga?" So I walked in there and I laid my verse, you know what I'm saying? I got a call, man, from KP, asked me that I want to go to LA to the Source Book. Do I want to go? I'm already there. What are you talking about? So I say that to say, that's the way my path was created, you know what I'm saying? And I had a lot of resentment for a lot of people that I feel like had an opportunity to reach out that didn't. At the time, but it wasn't my time. I had to realize that later. You know what I'm saying? I had to realize, I had to mature and I had to say, "Hey, look, Tim, don't nobody owe you nothing. Everybody else's way ain't your way." You know what I'm saying? And I had to grow into that. You know what I'm saying? JD, you ain't put me on Welcome to Atlanta. I was mad at you. I had a lot of things that, you know what I'm saying, I had to deal with within myself. Just like Divine say, wasn't nobody standing in line with him when he was made to live. Wasn't nobody buying them half ounces and 200 babies when I had to flip my packs. Wasn't nobody doing that when he was in his room. Win-win. But one thing you can't deny is intelligence and talent. Yeah. Now, Atlanta, we got to stick together and we got to recognize it. Just because your path ain't my path, just because my path went your path, that don't mean that we can't come together and we can't represent for one another. Just because I'm from the west side and I claim Bankhead, somebody else might be from the east side, they might claim Kirkwood, somebody else might be from the south side, they claim College Park, that don't mean that y'all can't represent together. Simply because, listen, what I do, what worked for me may not work for you. What worked for you, I'm not interested in doing. I got a really good thing going, my damn self. So man, let's just, you know what I'm saying, let's put our ego to the side, man. Because I mean, for real, for me, you know what I'm saying, I have an ego, but I'm confident enough in myself to where I can step aside from my ego because I'm confident in my own skin. I know what I can do. I know what I do nobody else can do. If they could, they'd have done it by now. So I can step aside away from my ego and I can say, "Hey man, you know what, man? If there's somebody out here to be helped, I'm gonna help them." But I'm gonna tell you this, a lot of people out there playing on a professional level, they don't deserve to be playing on a professional level. Divine, you started, I'm gonna finish it. Listen. Because of the internet and because of all the access that these youngsters have, they don't have to go through the proper challenge. You see, back in our day, we had what we call gatekeepers. You know what I'm saying? If your music make it to this man and it don't get past this man, guess what? You're not good enough. Keep moving. Right now, there are no gatekeepers. You get to make something in the bathroom, and just because you and the three homeboys that you got around you, right? Say, "Listen, you're gonna build my world star." You know what I'm saying? You're gonna get your iPhone, you wanna shoot you a video. You know what I'm saying? And now, you wanna say, "Hey, T.I., get on this." What? You on the level of me. Do you know how much work I put in? Do you know? Are you serious?
Oh my goodness.
And then they say, "Oh man, T.I. stuck up, man. He don't win Hollywood." Nah, man, I'm still Hollywood role, really, if you want to know. But I have a standard. I have a standard and I have integrity about my art. I take my art real serious, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm giving you my life here. From the first album to the next album, I'm giving you my life at that time. And that standard, I will not lower and I will not compromise that, not the integrity of my music for anybody, because that's what got me here. You understand that?
Yes.
And what I think people have been doing, because Atlanta is so popping right now, they feel like, well, I'm from Atlanta. I can get on through here. I ain't got to be as good because I'm from Atlanta. I got to go to Magic City, I got to throw some money up, I got to have a bunch of big girls in there, I got to say it. I'm going to get Future on the
room. Oh, shit.
I'm going to dance my way to the top.
This guy.
Sean! Sean! That ain't the way I learned. I can't teach nobody any different than I was learning. I would talk. You know what I'm saying? I would talk. Oh, go hard. Wow. Time after time. No matter who. In New York, I was hollering Bankhead. On the west side, Cali, I was hollering Bankhead. Before anybody knew what Bankhead was.
That's right.
Everybody's like, where's this place called Bankhead? This is going to be Christian light skin guy. Keep talking. I need to go there. And that's when it wasn't cool to say you was from Bankhead. That was you from rap. You know what I'm saying? So I thank y'all for honoring me so early in my life. and with the support of the team that I've had around me since day one, and the city that I've been representing from day one, I'm sure that I live long enough and be successful enough to be honored again. I appreciate your time and your prayers. Thank you.